The floor is yours, Fabrice.
Thanks, thanks, Gabor. So I'm going to start with a number. This is like a big number. It's 256 to the power 176. And this number, it takes like six lines to actually write it. So it's definitely big. And this is the number of tests that Fabien is going to show to you in the demo, and he's going to do live on a piece of code to do cryptography that you could download from the internet. So, next slide. What do we propose to do that? Actually, we propose Trust Instantiizer is a tool, technology which enables you to do this number of tests. So, our philosophy at Trust Instant, so the reason why together with Pascal and Benjamin we created Trust Instant is we wanted to empower the developers to test and fully master and control the software they have. This is why we bring to you a tool which enables to test all the possible behavior. Whatever happens in the environment of your code, you will be able to make sure that it always behave in a certain manner, or that it will never behave in some other manner which would be bad for you. Next slide. So where do we come from? So we were initially in a research center in France, working in the aeronautic. We today, I would say, we're market proven. That is, we have many generally kind of big customers as users throughout the world. So that's in Europe, in the US, in Asia as well, in China and in Japan. Today we are recognized by the NIST. So the NIST is the US federal body. They issued a report to the White House. And in this report, they say, okay, Trust Instant is able to mathematically guarantee that you do not have like 0 days, such as buffer overflows or stuff like that. This is not present. And why you remember the big number I've been showing to you at the beginning? We are able to test all the possible behavior of the software on something, in this case, which does some HTTPS encryption. But of course, we have many, many other kind of usages. We have several, I would say, big names also behind us. Typically, Linux Foundation helped us to develop. I will show you like the first level, like the super easy to use tool we have. And we also are recognized by the RSA conference as one of the most innovative companies. So next slide. So just to, I would say, to tell our story. Initially, we designed in the research center a technology to validate the code, like the most critical code you could find in an airplane, to validate for safety a piece of code in an airplane. So today we had a growing base in aeronautics, and not only we address cybersecurity, but we also address safety, sorry, but we also address cybersecurity. So this is, I would say, where we come from. Then we started to, I would say, tackle new domains, such as typically railway, space, automotive, also, which is like the picture in the middle. So today we have, for instance, customers such as Easymile, such as Baidu in China, or it could be Arm also, with just like the microcontroller. So I would say we start from the silicon up to the applicative level, so like the autonomous car, for instance, these kind of things. And last item, and this is something I was very proud of, because not only do we do critical system, which is fine, but we also do consumer electronics. So today we have customers who do phones, who do game. So, and even though they're not doing any critical device yet, there are so many devices on the field, so many game consoles, so many phones, that indeed making sure that you have a guarantee that never ever a piece of code is going to crash, or that it will always behave in a certain manner, this definitely is extremely useful. Next line. So I was talking about empowering our developers. So what do, how do we empower our users? I would say we have two axes. First axis, which is the one on the top, is we enable to assess the safety and the security. So we do that because we're able to exhaustively grasp a kind of defect. You don't have to, that is, if you want to have a result like in a few hours, this is possible. And then you're able, if you do put a little more time, to get like an exhaustive behavior. So it could be either just boosting the coverage of your test or reaching the exhaustive behavior as the NIST highlighted in the report. And this is something which is really up to you. Second column on the bottom is we enable our customer to save money. We enable our customer to save money by, I would say, being more efficient in the way they do tests. Typically, it's at least a factor of four. So if it takes you like 4 months to test a piece of code, definitely you can generally achieve the same amount of testing or even bigger in a very smaller time frame. What we also noticed is that our users generally, they tend to focus on the real issues because trust and soft is going to be automatic and automate tests. It leaves more time for the engineers to think about what matters, what makes sense, in which direction they should go. And they can go if they want up to a complete specification and prove that the specification is actually met on the software itself. When I say on the software, I mean on the source code itself. Next slide. So I would say we have a three-phase approach. First one, we call that the interpreter or level one. At this level, we simply replay the existing tests. So you could say it's almost like a sanitizer. The big thing is that this sanitizer is going to be exhaustive with the bugs which are in your existing test. So sometimes a sanitizer might not report an undefined behavior which is present in the test. So you will run your sanitizer, you will run your test, and say, oh, okay, everything is fine. Yet there is an undefined behavior that maybe you will notice later on, which is an issue. So we help you with level one to get the most out of your test. Indeed, you invested a lot of time in your test, and we are going to help you making sure that you get the most of the time that you invested in your existing test. This is level one. Then level two is the analyzer. You remember the big number at the beginning? This is exactly what we are able to do, is to progressively increase the number of tests that you can do so that if you want, you can reach an exhaustive coverage. Together with level one and level two, I would say that's more than 80% of our users. And then the last 20% would be the functional proof, that is proving that indeed a piece of code, a function or a method in C++ is doing exactly what it's supposed to do. Here, it takes a bit more time because somehow you need to specify what you want. We can't guess that. Yet, when you specify it, we can say, okay, what we specified is actually met on the code. Next slide, please. So, in summary, I would say today, what is used by most of our users is making sure that you do not have the undefined behavior. By undefined behavior, which are defined precisely in the C and C++ standard, we mean all the memory access issues like buffer overflow, access out of bound, invalid pointer usage, non-initialized variable, all those kind of bad memory stuff you can find in C. So we make C and C++ safer. This is what we do. But we do the same also for arithmetic operations. So division by zero, integer, sign of the flow, and all these kind of issues. We are also very fairly good on the floating point numbers, which is useful for several customers. We have both in aeronautic and in the automotive sector as well. So I see that there are some questions. How is it possible to guarantee the absence of undefined behavior? Okay, So you are going to have a demo. Fortunately, at the end of the demo, it will be better. And you remember that this big number of tests, actually, by making this number of tests, we are able like to handle all the possible behavior of the code, whatever happens, like in a buffer, which is red or this kind of thing. But I think you have a clear vision after the demo. So this is what you do. Next slide. So if I want to summarize, somehow we package. So why are we like so different from the other static analyzer? We package the power of formal methods, and somehow it's, I would say, mostly hidden to you so that you just get the benefits and you don't have the time it takes to actually use the formal method. So we make it easy to use, we make it enable every developer to benefit from formal methods, either for dynamic analysis or for static analysis. And we do that in an interactive manner where you are able to, at each step, follow what's going on and really be in control, be in the driver's seat and completely master what's going on in your code.